You're listening to Radio New Zealand International's Dateline Pacific. Concern has been raised about the potential for a whitewash over last month's Tumbi landslide in Papua New Guinea's Southern Highlands. The PNG coordinator for the International State Crime Initiative and lecturer in criminology at the University of Ulster, Christian Leslett, says there needs to be a comprehensive investigation into the landslide, which officials say buried at least 25 people. He fears that local concerns about the role of a quarry used by ExxonMobil's liquefied natural gas project in the area of the landslide have been dismissed without proper scientific analysis. Dr. Leslett told Johnny Blaze that the landslide tragedy can be compared to the ferry sinking disaster which happened the following week.
Nature could have played a role in both, but there is a degree of likeliness in both cases that human factors came into play. In respect to the Rabaul Queen, we've seen the O'Neill government come out with a very robust response, and they've obviously ordered a commission of inquiry. But whereas in the case of Tumbi, there has been no commission of inquiry, and in fact, all that we have to date is a fairly, flimsy report that has been put out by the National Disaster Committee, which is full of schoolboy errors.
How could the state get away with possibly whitewashing what might be a link to the project in it?
The Tumbi disaster occurred a day before a mutiny in Port Moresby, a week and a half before the worst maritime disaster in the history of the country. But at the same time, the more sceptical side of me feels that this could create a convenient environment where a whitewash could happen. And what we have seen is that LNG, most importantly, the landowners have come out from the Tumbi area. The local leaders have come out and stated very loudly that they want to have a independent inquiry. This has been supported by NGOs like LNG Watch and also by the PNG Trade Union Congress. So we've seen a variety of civic actors come behind this call for an independent inquiry. And, of course, the O'Neill government have made the right noises, but to this date there has been no clear plan, no clear agenda for this independent inquiry. Moreover, what we do have is, as I mentioned before, a report by the National Disaster Committee, and probably more troubling is that when this report was produced in collaboration with ExxonMobil, and obviously for the aggrieved family of victims, this will raise questions in their head. If on the 25th of January the government was already working in partnership with ExxonMobil, has this already compromised the investigation?
Christian Leslett from the University of Ulster speaking to Johnny Blades.